To start, I simply added text to my video. And then I went to the left, right clicked, new item, and then select the black video. And simply click OK. After that, click and drag it above your text. Then make sure you have your black video selected. Then go to effects controls and uncheck uniform scale. Then adjust the scale width to how thick you want the cursor to be. And decrease the scale height until the cursor is a bit taller than the text. Then go to position and adjust the first value in order to move the cursor to the beginning, and the second value in order to center it. Then go to the effects panel and search linear wipe. Then click and drag it to a text clip. After that, select the text clip and go to effects controls. Then move the time controller to the start of the clip. Then click the stopwatch next to transition completion to create your first keyframe. Then set the transition completion to 100%. Then move the playhead to roughly halfway through the clip. After that, set the transition completion value to 0% to create the ending keyframe. Then set the wipe angle to 270. Now let's review footage. To speed up the wipe, simply move the second keyframe closer to the first one. You have to play around with the speed in order to get it perfect. After that, go to black video and then move the playhead to the start. Then click the stopwatch next to position in order to create that keyframe. Now play the video and stop it when the text finishes its reveal. Then click and drag the first position value to the end of the text. Now this will automatically create the ending keyframe. Then move the playhead to the start of the clip. Then simply use the right or left arrow keys in order to scrub through the video. Then simply change the first position value in order to move the cursor. So basically, you want the cursor to be slightly ahead of the text. You don't want it to be too far ahead, but also don't too far behind. So as you can see, the effect looks really good by now. But if you want it to look even better or make it more natural, you need to extend the black video. But in order to make this, I recommend zooming in and simply extend the black video. After that, make a cut where the black video aligns with the text. Then move the playhead to the cut. Then make a cut every 3 to 4 frames. And to make a cut every frame, simply use your arrow key in order to move one frame at a time. Then we have some black video left over, simply delete it. Then start by deleting the first cut that we created, and then delete every other cut. Now, as you can see, the cursor is now blinking at the start of the clip. Now, to make the cursor blink at the end of the clip, simply move the playhead to where the cursor animation ends, then make a cut. Then we just do the same thing that we did earlier, make a cut every 3 to 4 frames. Then simply delete the first cut that we created and delete every other after that. Then you can simply delete the black video that we have left over because we don't need it anymore. And now we're done. We have made the typewriter effect.